Welcome. In the last two lectures, we derived an expression for electric tractive force and its components. In this particular lecture, we'll try to solve some numerical problems on electric traction. Let us discuss the problem number one. What do you mean by gradient grade of 1 in 100? You all know gradient means the gradient comes into effect when a locomotive tries to move up the hill or down the hill. Over here it is mentioned that the gradient grade is 1 in 100. To illustrate more, let me draw a diagram to illustrate this. Suppose we have an uphill here and this is the locomotive which is moving upwards. The gradient grade of 1 in 100 means if it covers a distance of 100 meter here, the elevation which it can achieve is 1 meter. So the gradient grade means gradient grade of 1 in 100 means by traveling 100 meters up the hill, the train elevates by a distance of 1 meter. It means it elevates by a height of 1 meter every 100 meter up the hill. If the gradient would have been mentioned as the gradient downgrade of 1 in 100 means it would have de-elevated by a height of 1 meter after every 100 meter down the hill. So it is a very good question to mention how this gradient will be mentioned in the upcoming numericals. Let us discuss our second problem. A train is going down the gradient of 1 in 150. Calculate the acceleration. Here we are not provided with any other information. That means we can consider that the train is moving only due to the action of gravity. That is, it is not being excited by any electrical or fuel. We know that tractive effort at the wheels is equal to force to accelerate the train plus or minus force to overcome the gravity effect plus force to overcome the resistive forces. Here there is no information about the resistive forces, so I will consider FR to be zero. As the train is not accelerating due to any excitation, so I will consider FA also to be zero. So that means FW will be equal to FG, where FW is the accelerative force or the tractive force, which will be equal to mass into acceleration. So this will be equal to mass, that is effective weight WE times the acceleration, and it will be equal to the force due to gradient or gravity, and it will be equal to 98 times WE times G, where G is the gradient. Gradient over here is mentioned as 1 in 50. That means G equal to 1 by 150 into 100. So this will be equal to 2 by 3. Substituting this value of G in this equation and cancelling out this WE with this WE, I will get A to be equal to 98 times 2 by 3. This is equal to 196 divided by 3, and this will further be equal to almost 65. So acceleration is 65 meter per second square. Let us consider our next question. In this question, a 200 ton motor coach driven by a 4 electric motors takes 20 seconds to attain a speed of 42 km per hour. Speed is mentioned to us, time is mentioned to us, that means by using these two we can calculate the acceleration of the train. The dead weight of the train is given to us, which is 200 tons, and it is an electric motor coach which is being driven by 4 electric motors. Starting from rest and ascending on a gradient of 1 in 80. Over here G is also mentioned to us, so let me write down what are the things that are mentioned to us. We are mentioned the dead weight of the train, which is W, which is 200 tons. Also, we are mentioned the acceleration. Acceleration will be equal to speed divided by time. and this will come out to be equal to 42 divided by 20 seconds. Solving it, I will get 2.1 kilometer per hour per second, per hour per second. Gradient g is also mentioned to us as 1 in 80. It means g will be equal to 1 divided by 80 into 100, as to mention it in percentage. So it will be 1.25. Further, a locomotive has a gear ratio of 3.5. Gear ratio, if you remember, gear ratio was mentioned as beta in the expression. So beta is given to us as 3.5. Gear efficiency of 92%. Gear efficiency was mentioned as eta. It is 92%. 92%. It means 0.92. And wheel diameter of 92 centimeter. Wheel diameter was capital D and it was 92 centimeter. Converting into meter, I will get 0.92 meters. Also, train is experiencing a resistance of 40 newton per ton. So this resistive force, that is R, resistive component, that is R, is mentioned to us as 40 newton per ton. Further, rotational inertia of 10% of the dead weight is mentioned to us. Rotational inertia of 10% of dead weight means, if you remember, I mentioned that while accelerating, the weight of the train changes to the effective weight, WE, which is generally 1.1% of dead weight, that is over the 110% of dead weight. So over here, the dead weight is mentioned to us W to be equal to 200. So WE will be the 10% of dead weight. Rotational inertia of the dead weight will be 10% of dead weight, and this will be equal to WE will be equal to 110% of dead weight. So on calculation, I will get this to be equal to 220 ton. Now let us see what we have to calculate. Calculate the torque developed by each motor. I have to calculate the torque developed by each motor. We have four electric motors here. They will be developing the overall torque. So after the calculation of overall torque, I need to divide that by 4 to calculate the torque developed by each motor. These are the things which are given to us. These are the things which are given. And let me write the formulas to be used here, which are the attractive force Fw to be equal to 2 times of eta beta into T divided by D, where this eta is the gear efficiency ratio, beta is the gear gear ratio, this T is the torque developed by the train or by the motor, and D is the diameter of the wheel, Fw is the tractive force. Also, Fw is also equal to 277.8 We times acceleration plus 98 times W times G plus W times R. This is the accelerative force, this is the force to overcome gravity, this is the force to overcome the resistive forces. Let us see what are we provided in these expressions. Over here, we are not provided with Fw. We have the value of eta, we have the value of beta, we have the value of T. We have eta, beta, but we do not have T. We have the value of D. We are required to calculate T. Also in this expression, we do not have this Fw, but we have this We, we have this A, we have this W, we have this G, we have this W, we have this R. So we have everything in this expression except this Fw. So that means we can calculate this Fw and substitute this value of Fw in this expression to calculate the value of T. So Fw will be 277.8 and we have We as 220. So we will substitute it with 220. We have the value of A as 2.1 kilometer per hour per second. So it is 2.1 plus 98 into W. W is 200 We'll mention it with 200. We have G. G as 1.25. So it is 1.25 plus W is again 200. And R is also mentioned to us as 440. So it will be into 40. Solving this, I will get 160868.6 Newton. This is the tractive force acting on the locomotive. Now, using this value of tractive force, we can calculate the total torque produced by the electric locomotive. So this T will be equal to the FW into D divided by 2 eta and beta. This will be equal to 160868.6 into D. D is we have 0.92 meters divided by 2 into eta. Eta we have again 0.92 into beta. Beta we have 3.5, so it is 3.5. On solving it, we get 22,981.23 Newton meters. This is the torque generated by the electromotive. This is actually the torque generated by the four electric motors. But we need to calculate the torque developed by each motor. So we need to divide this torque by 4 to calculate the torque developed by each motor. So the torque by each motor will be equal to 22,981.23 divided by 4, and this will come out to be 5,745.3 Newton meter. This is the required answer. So the strategy to solve this numerical was to first mention what are the given things and then to check what are the expression that we have. We have this expression and this expression, and then looking for what are the values that are provided to us, and then manipulating these two expressions to get the final answer.